It's been more than 50 days since the palace has been hiding Kate. Here's what we know on the subject and what conspiracy theory proponents are suggesting. The Royal Press Office released just two pieces of news on January 17. It was reported that the princess had been hospitalized for routine abdominal surgery. The palace warned that recovery would be long and asked not to expect her to appear in public until the end of March. On January 29, already not through the official website, but just in social networks, subscribers were notified that Kate was discharged from the hospital. 13 nights in the hospital is a very serious term, and the reason for such a long hospitalization should be much more serious than just indisposition. The royal family made Kate's illness a secret. This circumstance gives rise to all sorts of rumors and the most terrible conjectures. It is clear to everyone that the condition of the 42-year-old princess is much worse than the condition of the 75-year-old king. This is the reasoning of royal experts in the program Good Morning Britain. The expert says that it is very unusual that two sad news about the health of the royal family members appeared at the same time. It is also unusual that the king is constantly in plain sight, both before and after the hospital visit. The princess is hidden from us, and her press spokesperson reminds reporters of her desire for privacy and asks them not to pay so much attention to her surgery. The palace is silent about what really happened to the princess, but we are reading too many, even the smallest details about the king's health. It looks like this is how people are trying to distract and shift their attention from Kate to Charles. The expert notices that the king is clearly covering for Kate. That's the reason they were discharged from the same clinic on the same day. But the difference is too obvious. The king left the clinic on his own feet. How it left the princess, it is unclear. British paparazzi took the hospital building in a tight ring, and all 2 weeks were on duty there around the clock. They managed to find out that Prince William visited his wife once in 2 weeks. Journalists did not see any parents, children or aides. For this reason, analysts agree that the princess had a very hard time with the surgery. She either fell into a coma herself or was plunged into it artificially. Details of this are told not by British, but by Spanish journalists. According to them, the operation itself ended badly, and the post-operative period was unsuccessful. Doctors had to make radical decisions because of complications. Complications threatened the life of the princess and left doctors no choice. Kate had to be put into an artificial coma. The anxiety in the royal family was palpable. Now there is an argument going on in the palace what to tell the nation. After the news about Kate's coma appeared, the British press was tasked to refute these rumors, but for this purpose the palace did not provide any information, no facts proving the opposite, and journalists were forced to get creative. The journalist announced on television that she was lying with Kate in neighboring wards. One day in the corridor, Prince William rushed past her and carried her down the corridor to his wife's room. The fact that no one saw him there, the lady explained, simply, after all, photographers were not allowed inside. But she saw the running prince with her own eyes. News has emerged that the princess communicates daily by video link with her children and has even begun to perform her royal duties remotely. No one in Britain believed in such a performance without serious proof, and they are still not there. Especially doubted after rumors that Kate was brought straight from the hospital to the cottage Adelaide on the territory of Windsor Castle. Everyone following the news from the royal family is aware that the cottage is very cold and too small. There is no room even for a nanny. The ailing princess was then immediately moved to Sandringham Manor in West Norfolk. In the meantime, it seems to many that Prince William is on the verge of a breakdown. He made his first public appearance on February 7, spent more than a month on maternity leave, and left his royal duties for that time. While picking up the order at Windsor Castle, the prince dropped it. His hands and eyelids trembled, and he gave the impression of a man who was about to faint. That evening, at a reception in honor of the London Ambulance Service, he made a joke that made everyone sad. British conspiracy theorists claim that the princess simply escaped from the royal family, which has a habit of lumping together the nation's most beloved princesses. After all, Kate Middleton's subjects love as much as they love Princess Diana, and are very afraid that the second Princess of Wales will suffer the fate of the first, and she will die prematurely. The royal family is playing its main role as a screen to divert the attention of the people from the pressing issues at hand. I like the version that Kate simply ran away, as Princess Charlene of Monaco did. What about you? If you liked the video, Then don't forget to put a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the latest news about the royal family.